If you want to program your Teensies with the new Arduino IDE version 2.0, here's how you do it. First, let's get the application. Now that it's downloaded, let's install. I have just read the licensing agreement and I agree with everything, and I'm going to install this for just myself. I'm going to take all the defaults. This process takes a few minutes, so I'm going to speed the video up. All right, now the installation is complete, let's fire everything up. If you're wondering why I haven't downloaded the TeensyDuino, it's because you don't need to. The software will take care of that. Let me show you how. When you start the software for the first time, you'll probably get a small message at the very bottom of the screen to install your AVR boards. I'm going to go ahead and hit yes. This will take a few minutes. Now that that's installed, time to get the TeensyDuino. What you're going to do is go to File, Preferences, and in the Additional Boards Manager, you're going to add the string, this JSON string. You can get this from the PJRC website, or I will have it in the description. Click OK. It's downloading the package. Then, if you go to the Boards Manager and type in Teensy, you can install the boards. All right, now that that's complete, we should be able to select our board. You can go to the old-fashioned tools, board, and see your Teensy list here. Or you can go right to the top menu bar and go to select other boards and type Teensy and select your boards from there. Either way works fine. The nice thing about this system here is if you go to File, Preferences, you'll notice that there is a sketch location. That is created when you start up, and you can place all of your libraries in that location. So if you uninstall your Arduino IDE, all of your libraries are intact. So if you write your own libraries, if you take an existing library that was delivered with the platform and hack it up, make your own copy of it, you can place it in this location. If you download some libraries, you put everything in that location, and it will be preserved upon an uninstall, and it will be reinstated on a reinstall. Hopefully this helps.